what's your biggest area of research right now?
We are working on developing CRISPR technologies. So we focus on making the tools efficient, more robust, and also expanding the toolbox so that we can realize more ways to be able to treat disease.
So delivery is very important. That's your prime role right now?
Delivery is one of the important areas in the lab that we're trying to develop solutions for.
Do you think there could come a time when we understand that CRISPR can't be used in humans? Is that possible?
I think there are a lot of work that still need to be done to understand how well the technology works, how efficient the system is, and there are a lot of steps, and we just need to take one step at a time to figure out how well this technology is and how far we can go.
You're involved in several companies right now. Did it surprise you going from the scientific community to becoming something of a businessman?
I'm a scientist through and through. I'm really interested in translating the technology so that we can one day use it to benefit patients and benefit the public. And I think there are a lot of scientific and technical hurdles that we'll have to overcome. And so through both my academic lab and also through working with smart drug developers, we're hoping that we'll be able to get this out into the world so that it can benefit people.
You've heard about the FDA's delay, we don't know how long, for the clinical trials of CTX. Do they call it CTX-0001? Does it concern you in any way that the Food and Drug Administration has put this first clinical trial on hold?
I think the FDA is playing a very important role in trying to make sure that technology is developed thoughtfully and also carefully. So I think it's taking the right steps to think about these technologies and really be careful as we move forward into clinical testing. I think I have a lot of faith in the FDA. They are very smart people, and I think they're doing the right thing.
If you had unlimited resources, how would you focus it?
I think there are a lot of issues to address, delivery being one of the major ones, which I think we need a lot of resources to be able to address. And then beyond that, further developing the system to make the editing more efficient across a broad range of tissue types. These are the things that we are focusing on, and I think will still require a lot of resources to fully realize.
In your lifetime, what would you like to accomplish? What would you like to see the outcome be when you look back?
I think one of the things I would really love to see is if we can use this to treat diseases and improve people's lives. I get emails from patients frequently, and that just underscores how much more we still need to do and how we have the potential to be able to benefit the world. And so we need to get there, and we owe it to all the people for this opportunity to be able to make real beneficial things for the world.
We see the potential for CRISPR dealing with genetic diseases that exist. What about prevention of those diseases? Would that be a prenatal issue that might be more challenging to deal with?
I think right now the technology is still early. And one of the things that we're focused on is to use it to treat diseases in the adult, in the body, so that we can try to improve lives of patients who suffer from, say, sickle cell disease or cystic fibrosis or hemophilia, many of these genetic diseases.
How has your life changed as a result of the notoriety you've gained, 60 Minutes and other and publications? How has that changed the way you are perceived, perhaps, in the scientific community?
I'm still focused on trying to move the science forward. I go into lab every day, continue to enjoy working with my students to think about how do we further develop this technology, and identifying the important problem areas, prioritizing them, and then try to develop solutions to knock down these challenges one at a time.